Hey guys, Jason Sayers back here once again with another drum reaction video. Today, firstly, let me apologize about this thing here. DIY is a dangerous hobby sometimes, and accidents do happen, but never mind, it's only a small thing. That's what she said. I'm going to stop it with the really bad jokes. Today, I am checking out a request that you guys have sent to me. Had quite a few of you mention a drummer called Bill Ward, who played for Black Sabbath for a little while, and you sent over a track, well, the track, War Pigs from 1970, and yeah, I'm with you, I can't wait to see it. Let's dive right in.
We're going to number now called War Pigs. It's a number of our new LP. Hope you like it, thank you.
Ozzy is crazy as ever. Oh, did that change? Love these old drum sounds. That snare drum is thundering. I swear, the 1970s, they knew what they were doing with audio. Bonham-esque about the drum sound I'm hearing. Sounds really familiar. Bonham. It's an interesting drum setup I spotted as well. I swear these old kits setups are mental. Cymbal sounds don't look strong enough. Yeah.
beast appears. It is falling at his knees. He sends out Europa.
Laying his back here.
Oh, Lord, yeah.
Ooh, that was nice. Interesting kit setup. It's probably a good setup back in the time. I like that one. Lord, that guy was literally beating that kit like it owed him money. Wow, to maintain that. He had dynamics with it during the fast sort of. Can you call it a blast? Yes, I did. Let's call it a blast. In the blast section, all forearm with wrist at that speed. That, yeah, like. They're all off of their heads on drugs, quite clearly. Or narcotics, whatever you want to call them. But man, I can feel his pain, but he was just going for it. Wow. The drum setup. I know a lot of you drummers out there are like, yeah, that was a standard setup back then. It's like, okay, I didn't see them, but what an interesting setup. It looked like the ride stand or the crash stand was coming directly off the side of the bass drum. Really, really odd. The sound, though, those boys from the 1970s knew what they were doing with audio. Like, yes, there's not a lot of low end or anything like that, but everything was crystal clear with clarity. Let me get my words out properly. And the snare, I always comment about other people's snares. It's because I can't really hear mine whenever I play it. I usually use my Joey Jordison snare, but man, those sort of snares, I think it was a Ludwig. I'm pretty sure I spotted it being might have been a Supraphonic or something like that. Wow. Sounds so good. And I don't know what you thought about him as a drummer. There was definitely some Bonham moments there. Like, obviously, Bonham was massive at the time, and you know, but did these inspirations start already at that point, you know, for the tonality of the drums, the way it was playing, or was it just literally the jazz influence at the time really just coming through in everyone's playing? You know, I'd love to know what you guys think about that. Please leave it in the comments down below. Yeah, that was phenomenal. If you guys want to check out any other videos of fantastic drummers and you want to watch me watch them, then please also leave them in the comments box down below. I would be most grateful. Also, you can join my Discord server where you can just ping me over video links, you know, funny things, whatever you want to send, really, as long as it's drum related and we can all have a laugh at it. Game on. Anyway, thanks a lot, guys. If you're new around here, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you never miss one of my future videos. I mean it now. Do it. I'm trying to break that 3,000 subscriber point. It's almost there, and you can make it happen. If you like my content and want to check out any more videos, they'll be appearing on screen now. Cheers, guys. Catch you on the next one.